Hi, I'm going to show a walkthrough of the multi-camera sim to deploy workflow. I'm first going to deploy the real-time location system packaged with default synthetic data and then customize it with newly generated synthetic data from IsaacSim. For more information about the real-time location system, the user can visit the multi-camera AI real-time location system quick start page. We also recommend the user read through the prerequisites and the architecture overview for more information about the deployment. For this walkthrough, I'm going to follow the instructions at the Setup the Workflows in the Cloud section. Let's get started. First, download the package from NGC and untar it. You should be able to see similar files. Next, go ahead and edit the deploy-template.yaml and the secrets.sh file. You can see samples for the same in the appendix section of the documentation. Now, we're ready to deploy the Metropolis RTLS app. To deploy the RTLS app, run the bash mtmc app deploy install command. This might take a few minutes. I've already done so on my system. To show the results of the deployment, run the show results command. Next, navigate to the Explore RTLS Workflow section and click on the Verify Deployment link. Here, you'll find the command to connect to the application instance. After connecting, you can check on the status of the application deployment by running kubectl get pods. You can see that all my pods are running, but during a first-time deployment, this might take a while. After all our pods are in the running state, it's time to check out the UI. Run the show results command again. Copy the web address at albdnsname. Append /VMS to check out the VMS dashboard. We can see that we have 12 active sensors. To check out any sensor, go to Live Streams and select its ID. Now, let's check out the RTLS UI. Simply add /UI/RTLS at the end. Here, we can see that we have real-time location of several characters in a global floor plan. We can also see icons for the cameras that have been placed. We can also visualize their field of view. Below is the count of the total number of people being tracked in the scene. Next, let's generate new synthetic data and see how we can customize the RTLS app. I'm going to follow the steps at the SDG workflow section to deploy IsaacSim using IsaacSim Automator. Let's get started. Download the artifacts from NGC by running this command. Next, untar the package, then build, and then run. After completing the steps, you should see a Docker container for IsaacSim Automator running. Next, let's get into this container. Here, we need to fill in the sdgdeploy.txt file and also the credentials file in the /uploads folder. After this, we're ready to deploy. Next, go back to the /app root folder and run the following command. This will deploy IsaacSim. It might take a few minutes. I've already done so on my system. Next, to view the results of the deployment, go to the state folder. Here, info.txt will have all the information required to connect to the instance via NoMachine. Once IsaacSim Automator completes its deployment, you should be able to connect via the NoMachine client and see the following UI. Now, let's start with our SDG. First, go to Windows, Extensions, and enable the OmniReplicator agent extensions. This should open up a few panels on the right-hand side. Go to Agent SDG and click on Setup Simulation. This will load the required warehouse stage. It might take a few minutes. Once the warehouse scene loads, click on the eye icon and deselect the grid. The ORA extension creates a simulation based on the values provided in the Agent SDG panel. For example, the default value for camera number is 12. We can see that ORA has placed 12 cameras in the scene. ORA tries its best to have good camera placement, but this is not always possible. Let's go take a look at each camera and make sure it has a good view. To check a camera's view, just click on the camera ID in this panel. To change a camera's view, hold the right mouse button down and use WASD to move the camera. Repeat this step for every camera to ensure all cameras have a good view. For the best possible RTLS results, it's important that we have good coverage of the entire asset. Once we're happy with the cameras, we can move on to characters. The default character number in the Agent SDG panel is 8. To take a look at this 8 character, let's go to the Stage panel. Let's minimize root, click on the World Prim, click on Characters, and select a character we want to view. After selecting the character, press F. This should zoom the camera onto the character. Next, let's generate random commands for these characters. Simply click on the Generate Random Commands button in the Character Settings panel. This will create commands equal to the simulation length that's mentioned in the Configuration File panel. For now, we've set this to 600 seconds. Click on Save Commands. The user is free to edit the commands for any character they like. Or they can generate a new set of random commands by changing the seed and clicking the Generate Random Commands again. For now, I'm going to stick with the defaults. So far, we've loaded a warehouse asset. We created some cameras and adjusted them to our liking. We then created some characters, generated some commands for them to perform. This is all the steps needed for our simulation. We can test the simulation out by clicking on the play button on the left panel. We can see a few characters move and perform actions. You can view the full simulation, but for now, I'm gonna stop. Once we're happy with the simulation we've created, it's time to decide what to capture in the simulation. Go to the Replicator Settings panel and select the Tile Writer. Next, check the RGB and the BB box. Now, we're all set to generate some data. Scroll up and click on Start Data Generation. Data generation might take a while to start. You'll note that data generation has started when the play icon changes to a stop icon. We can see that data generation has started. We can also check on the logs below. Data generation might take a while to complete. We can always stop data generation prematurely by clicking on the stop icon. But for the best RTLS results, we recommend at least 10 minutes of video length. We know that data generation is completed when the stop button turns back into the play button. Next, open a terminal and go into the IsaacSim Docker. Here, we're going to run some commands to create videos from the RGB images that we generated. Video creation might take a few minutes. The logs for videos, video creation, is at IsaacSim Video Creation Logs. After the videos have been generated, we can proceed with uploading them to an S3 bucket. Go back to the RTLS deployment and run the show results command to find the S3 bucket that was deployed. Head back to IsaacSim Automator and run the following command to upload the videos to the S3 bucket. The command will automatically find the video files that have been generated and upload them to the corresponding S3 bucket. After the videos have been uploaded, we can proceed with generating the calibration artifacts that are needed by the RTLS app to provide a global view. To generate the calibration artifact, click on the Calibration Tool widget. Next, fill in the following information. Next, we'll need to create a top view image. To do this, we'll need to modify the asset slightly. First, let's zoom out. Hold down the right mouse button and press S to zoom out of the asset. Next, make sure that window.section extension is enabled. You can do so by going to Window Extensions and searching for window.section. Next, close the extension window and go to Tools and enable the Window Dot section. You should see the following UI pop up. Next, bring up the Property panel. Change the following transform values to 0. This modifies the asset by removing the ceiling, but keeping the base of the asset intact. Next, hide the Display Section Manipulator. Go to Stage, and hide the characters from the stage. Next, go to Calibration Tool, and click on Create Top View Camera. This should populate the top view camera path with the placed top view camera. You can also view this top view camera from the camera icon. This is going to act as the floor plan for the RTLS app. We are now ready to create all the calibration artifacts. Click on Create.prims. After Create.prim finishes, click on Generate Calibration File. After Generate Calibration File finishes, go to the top left icon, select Viewport, and change the render resolution from 720p to 1080p. Finally, click on Generate Top View Image. After creating the calibration artifact, open up the terminal and run the following command to create the image.metadata.json file. Next, upload all the calibration artifacts to the deployed S3 bucket by running the following commands. Now, we are ready to use the newly generated synthetic data with the RTLS app. Next, I'll be following the instructions that use generated data in RTLS workflow to use our custom synthetic data with the RTLS app. Run the following command to create a config.json file. Next, copy-paste the template from the documentation. Next, update all the S3 bucket fields as follows. Also, put in your NGC API key at the NGC CLI API key field. Once the parameters are updated, execute this command to let the RTLS app update with the new synthetic data. Once the command completes, we can check the status of the application by running a kubectl get pods. Once all the pods are in the running state, we can now check the UI. On the VST UI, we can see that all 12 sensors are up and running. We can view a sensor by going to Live Streams, selecting a sensor ID. We can now check out the RTLS UI. We can see that the floor plan and cameras have been updated to match the newly created synthetic data. We can also see the real-time global location of the characters performing the generated commands. We have successfully customized our RTLS workflow to use the newly created synthetic data. This concludes the demo.